Today, I'm going to test the newest flagship laser cutter from xTool, the xTool P3. This is an 80-watt CO2 laser cutter with a large working area, packed with state-of-the-art technology, which makes it one of the most advanced laser cutters on the market today. All that tech also makes it one of the easiest laser cutters to use. It packs more automation and smart features than I've ever seen in a desktop laser. It's incredibly user-friendly, perfect for artists and crafters, yet powerful enough to impress technically minded users like me. In this video, we'll go through everything, from setup and hardware design to camera accuracy, cutting and engraving performance, and even some real creative projects to see what this thing can really do. In this video, I'll put the xTool P3 through a series of technical tests to see how it performs and how it compares to the smaller xTool P2S. Be sure to check my review of this machine as well. This is xTool's largest machine by far, featuring an enormous working area of 36 inches by 18 inches, or 91.5 by 45.8 centimeters. To give you a better idea of just how big that is, here's a plywood sheet of that exact size, placed neatly on the machine bed. Now, when I take that same board to my xTool P2S, you can see it's almost as large as the entire machine itself. And just for fun, here's a banana for scale. The xTool P3 has a very clean and simple interface. On the left side, you'll find a USB-C port for computer control and a USB lock key that disables the machine when removed, preventing unauthorized use. The xTool P3 also supports Wi-Fi connectivity. At the back, there's a power port, coolant port, and exhaust port. The P3 doesn't have a built-in exhaust fan, but every unit comes standard with the xTool IF2 inline fan and a long exhaust hose for venting fumes out a window. This setup provides both stronger fume extraction and more flexibility. If you have nearby neighbors or want an even cleaner workspace, you can pair it with the new xTool AP2 Max Air Purifier, a professional-grade filtration system designed for this laser. On the opposite side, there's a mounting spot for a CO2 fire extinguishing bottle, which automatically puts out any internal fire, should one ever occur. Next to it, you'll find the coolant drainage hose. I also highly recommend getting the xTool mobile workstand table, which fits the machine perfectly. It even has a hole in the center for placing taller items underneath when needed. The table features high-quality wheels, and assembling it is almost like building a Lego set thanks to the clever notch design. The machine weighs about 105 kilograms, around 230 pounds, but with this table, it's easy to move around the workshop. On this table, you can install two plywood boards to use as additional shelves for material. I only installed the bottom one as I ran out of plywood, but the table comes with brackets for another one higher up. A movable table is also essential if you plan to use the conveyor feeder, which I'll showcase later in the video. Inside the machine, there's a large auto-lifting slat bed with calibration dots for automatic camera alignment, a very convenient feature. The xTool P3 has multiple cameras inside, one on the lid for a wide-angle view of the working area and for monitoring the engraving process when the lid is closed. Then it has a close-view camera on the laser module to take very precise top-down photos of the material. And it has another side-view camera used for monitoring the engraving process. There is also a fourth camera, which is probably used for identifying engraving lens and maybe also for fire detection. Unlike some other models, the P3 doesn't need a riser base, since it already provides plenty of vertical space. It's powered by large stepper motors capable of speeds up to 1,200 millimeters per second, which is twice as fast as the P2S, with three times the acceleration. Here is a video of the machine running at full speed. It also supports the xTool RA3 Rotary attachment, which now includes bulk engraving, letting you take full advantage of the P3's massive workspace. The laser module itself has also been upgraded. The beam entry now has a protective cover to keep smoke from contaminating the mirror. A very cool addition is the interchangeable lens system. The medium M lens comes standard. The small S lens provides a finer laser spot for ultra-precise engraving, and the large L lens is optimized for cutting thicker materials thanks to its longer focus beam. The xTool P3 stands by its claim to be the easiest to use laser cutter as it has automatic camera calibration, automatic bed leveling calibration, and very easy process for optical path calibration. Everything that you need to make it work perfectly. These processes can be very fiddly and time-consuming on other machines. On top of the lid, there's a wide-angle camera that captures the entire work area, while the laser head houses a close-up camera and a LiDAR distance sensor for autofocus. You can also purchase the optional 5-watt infrared laser module, which allows engraving on uncoated metals and some plastics. Under the top lid of the laser module, you'll find an additional Z-axis motor that moves the lens up and down. It's used for adjusting focus in real time when engraving curved surfaces. One of my favorite features is the rotating control knob with an integrated high-fidelity display. You can control basic functions like raising or lowering the bed, monitor engraving progress, and toggle auto mode, also known as ACS, Automatic Creation System, which I'll demonstrate next. The xTool P3 works exclusively with the new xTool Studio software. At first, I was a bit disappointed that Lightburn isn't supported, but I quickly changed my mind. xTool Studio has become a very mature and capable platform, and it unlocks the P3's full potential. The xTool Studio is free and doesn't require any subscriptions. It's also what makes the P3 arguably the easiest to use CO2 laser on the market. So I didn't miss Lightburn at all when using the xTool P3. xTool Studio includes a large material library with predefined engraving and cutting parameters for all kinds of materials. It also features a project library with ready-to-make designs, like this cute hedgehog decoration. You'll find a library of vector shapes and icons, along with various generators that can create arrays, barcodes, QR codes, material test patterns, and even templates for earrings, keychains, boxes, and more. New features are added all the time. And don't forget AI Make, which can automatically transform your photos into engraving-ready designs. Another clever feature is automatic camera stitching, which combines close-up camera views to give you an accurate, high-resolution view of larger areas. It even works on the conveyor feeder, which I will show later in the video. One of the coolest innovations is, without a doubt, the ACS, Automatic Creation System. This feature makes the P3 almost effortless to use, even for complete beginners. Here's how it works. The cameras scan the material, the LiDAR measures the distance, and the machine automatically adjusts focus. All you need to do is place your material on the bed. To make my test more challenging, I placed multiple objects on the bed for batch engraving. Once the camera LED turns green, you can close the lid. The software automatically detects all objects. I placed my design on one of them, selected the appropriate material from the library, and the software automatically applied the design to the rest. Before engraving, the machine measures each piece and adjusts focus individually. Then it's just a matter of pressing start, and you're done. It's incredibly smart and genuinely beginner-friendly. Next, I ran a series of performance tests to see how well the xTool P3 handles real-world cutting and engraving tasks. I started by engraving several test patterns at double the speed I used on the P2S, just to compare performance between the two machines. First, I performed a cutting test on a 3mm plywood board at very high speeds, and the P3 managed to cut cleanly at an incredible 75 millimeters per second. That's seriously fast for a CO2 laser of this size. Then, I moved on to my standard cutting test patterns, the same ones I previously ran on the smaller xTool P2S. Since the P3 is significantly more powerful, I repeated the tests at double the speeds I used on the P2S. And just to note, on the P2S, I used millimeters per minute units instead of millimeters per second, so the speed numbers aren't directly comparable without conversion. Looking at the plywood cutting performance, the results were excellent. With 3mm plywood, the P3 cut flawlessly, maintaining clean edges with no issues. At 6mm thickness, it was roughly 50% faster than the P2S, a noticeable improvement in throughput. However, when looking at the two-pass column, I suspect that the effective speed was capped around 50 millimeters per second due to the smaller size of the shapes being cut. Even so, that's still an impressive result. And when I moved on to 10 millimeter plywood, the P3 continued to perform extremely well, cutting cleanly and consistently through thicker material without difficulty. When cutting 3 millimeter thick acrylic, the performance was the same as with cutting 6 millimeter plywood. We can see that the xTool P3 can reliably cut acrylic at 20 and 30 millimeters per second in a single pass. I also tested the 10 millimeter thick acrylic, which was cut at around 8 millimeters per second in a single pass. Next, I wanted to test the camera positioning accuracy. I used a sheet of anodized aluminum, which engraves beautifully, and positioned a circle perfectly around an existing hole using the near field camera. The result was as precise as it gets, absolutely spot on. The camera alignment accuracy is phenomenal, and it can save you a lot of material since you can utilize every millimeter of your workpiece, just like I did here. Then, I moved on to test the xTool P3's maximum engraving speed by running it at 1,200 millimeters per second. It's genuinely mesmerizing to watch such a large laser head move that fast. Even at that incredible speed, the P3 still has plenty of power in reserve, allowing it to engrave deep and consistently. The result was perfect, and having the ability to engrave at this speed can save a tremendous amount of time on large-scale projects. The xTool P3 is advertised as being able to cut 25mm acrylic using the L lens. Luckily, I had some 25mm acrylic on hand, so I ran a test at full power and 1mm per second. Even with the standard M lens, it was able to make the cut. I also tried cutting a more intricate shape, and it handled that beautifully too. I'm genuinely impressed. With the L lens, the cuts would likely be even cleaner and faster. Then, I moved on to an 18mm thick spruce board. This soft wood cuts fairly easily, though the knots and glue pockets can cause issues. By running it slowly at about 70% power, the P3 cut through in a single pass. The cut showed minimal charring and left a nice warm brown edge. Next, I installed the conveyor feeder, and the process was surprisingly simple. First, I removed a few screws from the magnetic doors on both sides of the machine. Then, I took the conveyor module, which features grippy steel rollers, and mounted it to the back of the machine. The conveyor module is secured with screws and can remain installed even when it's not in use, which is a really nice touch. After that, I attached another roller unit to the front, and then slid the feeder rails into place on both sides. These rails are fully adjustable, allowing you to accommodate boards of different widths. Once everything was in position, I slid the board into the machine and ran a stitching preview to see how well it could visualize larger boards. The machine automatically moved the board to detect its edges, so there's no risk of it falling off the rollers. The resulting preview image was incredible. You can't even tell where the camera images are stitched together. To really test it, I used a board with a distinctive wood pattern, and it passed perfectly. Then I proceeded to run a large cutting job using a vector design I purchased from Etsy. The conveyor feeder processing worked flawlessly. I'll admit I was initially skeptical about how reliable this system would be, but the alignment was spot on. No slippage, no drift, just perfectly continuous cuts. The final result came out beautifully. A wall art piece that's definitely going up on my wall. After use, it's recommended to remove the front roller, which I now store conveniently at the back of the machine. Both the front and rear doors are magnetic, so you can simply close them when you're done. Quick and easy. And if you plan to engrave or cut very long boards, I definitely suggest getting the conveyor extension module, which helps support extra long materials and ensures smooth feeding throughout the process. Now let's take a look at some cool project ideas which you can do with the xTool P3. For a fun project, I decided to make a toolbox drawer organizer, something I've always wanted to try on a laser. I used a free app that converts a photo of your tools into custom drawer inserts. I had plenty of 20mm packaging foam saved from old shipments, perfect for this job. The P3's large bed could easily fit a full drawer in one go, but for this demo, I cut a smaller sample. The P3 sliced through the thick foam effortlessly, and the result looked fantastic. All that's left is to glue the foam insert onto a plywood base or a thinner foam sheet. Using the box generator app in xTool Studio, I created a beautiful gift box for a beer bottle. I decided to cut it from a warped plywood sheet just to see how well the P3 could handle uneven materials. By using the included slat bed clips, I was able to straighten the wood perfectly before cutting. The flex section of the design required a lot of intricate cuts, but thanks to the P3's high cutting speeds, the entire box was finished surprisingly quickly. The result looked fantastic, a unique and thoughtful gift idea for special occasions. If you own an acrylic bending machine, you can take full advantage of the P3's large working area to create custom drawers or display cases, since it cuts thick acrylic effortlessly, almost like butter. You can also make great use of leftover acrylic sheets by turning them into promotional keychains or small gifts. The P3 cuts acrylic extremely cleanly, leaving crystal clear, polished edges, and it can handle acrylic of any color. Using the box generator, you can even design and assemble beautiful transparent acrylic boxes. I also explored the large built-in shape library in xTool Studio to design some fun keychains and even custom playing cards. A great way to experiment and create personalized accessories. After testing the xTool P3, it's clear this is one of the most powerful and refined laser cutters in its class. The 80-watt laser, dual cameras, and lighter autofocus make it incredibly fast and precise. And with xTool Studio and the automatic creation system, it's also one of the easiest CO2 lasers to use. Cutting performance is excellent, engraving quality is top tier, and the large working area combined with accessories like the conveyor feeder and rotary make it a truly versatile machine. If you want a professional-grade laser that's powerful, reliable, and easy to use, the xTool P3 definitely delivers. If you enjoyed this review, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell for more laser tests and projects. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.